Hello everyone, my name is Miquel Powell. I'm the founder of the Reentry and Community Development Center. Welcome to Marketview Heights. Scio Street is a part of Marketview Heights, and it's the location that we're asking the City of Rochester to invest $5 to $7 million to build homes, businesses, aesthetics, resurrect the playground, provide grants to the existing homeowners in this historic Black neighborhood. This neighborhood on Scio Street has not seen any new investment in the last 40 years. Join me as I take you through this neighborhood, which is a historically Black oppressed neighborhood, and we're asking the city to invest $5 to $7 million on homes and businesses.
It's been a long time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Oh, yes, it will. It's been too hard living, but I'm afraid to die.
Welcome. This is the Weld Street Park. It's a part of the Scio Street Homes and Business Development Project. We're asking the city to invest into this project so that we can resurrect this park so that Black kids can have a safe place to play. When I was growing up here in the neighborhood, we had swings here, monkey bars, seesaws. We played football in this park, kickball, dodgeball. So we're asking the city to invest into this Black neighborhood so that we can build a community again.
I believe the Marketview Heights Urban Program left out a vast majority, over 75% of the Scio Street area, effectively redlining the Scio Street neighborhood. And with this initiative, we're asking the city to use their vacant lots to build 25 to 30 new homes, to create buildings to allow for small business upstarts.
The Scio Street project would help this community thrive in a historically Black neighborhood where you can see all around it, people are losing. People are losing homes, they're losing an education, they're losing an opportunity. To revitalize this neighborhood would give hope to a generation of people who have lost hope due to broken systems, due to feeling left out. With the revitalizing of Scio Street will bring Black people back the love, the joy, the common unity that we once had.
I think it would give it a sense of community. I mean, the playgrounds, you know, every kid deserves to be a kid. It gives them a place to go, bringing in new homes, nicer homes, businesses, giving people a sense of pride in where they live and a sense of being valued by the city they live in.
So also redeveloping the Weld Street Park, which has been divested and taken away for so many years, and allowing these recreational opportunities for children, which would just be a given anywhere. But most important, I believe in redeveloping and reinvesting in existing neighborhoods before developing new ones.
Minister Franklin Florence believed that if you want common unity, you have to meet the basic needs of people. They have to have quality homes. They have to have recreation for children and their families. That's how you build community, by having common places for people to meet that are safe. You have to have viable education, viable businesses. So the 60s really built the platform for what we're doing now. And it's a sad thing, 50 years later, little has changed.
I think ultimately it's not that complicated. The people who live here are Rochesterians. This is Rochester. Instead of bending over backwards to find money for a police station no one wants, they should listen to community voices about what the community actually needs.
This is the site of the Innerloop overpass that's leading into the historic Scio Street neighborhood. Just on the other side is an affluent white neighborhood on University Avenue. We're asking the city to invest into this black neighborhood before you fill in the Innerloop. And this investment will cover 20 to 25 new homes, black businesses, aesthetics, existing grants for home ownership, and to resurrect the Weld Street Park.
No, I don't think they deserve re-election, and I think they need to answer to the people who live there.
Because he was born and raised here, this is his neighborhood. He understands what the community needs.
Join us in reaching out to your city council and Mayor Lovely Warren to insist that they make this investment into this historically black neighborhood. Thank you. My name is Miquel Powell, and I appreciate you so much.
But I know.